In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 5 online businesses that you could start in 2018. But what I'm also going to be doing is giving you some ideas of how you could scale those for massive success. Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And of course, if you're new here, welcome. My name is Erin, and this channel is all about helping you to build the business and life of your dreams. Now, what I wanted to do in today's video was talk about 5 businesses that you can start in 2018. But, you know, not just to make this an ordinary video, because I know there's thousands of blog posts and probably hundreds of thousands of videos with the same topic, and they all probably say the same thing. What I actually wanted to do was to give you some ideas about how you could scale these. You know, there's a difference between just starting a business when you start entry level, you've got no experience and you're kind of just finding your feet, to where the possibilities are, you know, for where you to go. It is a quantum leap, but knowing exactly what the possibilities are for you might help you be motivated to actually put in more of the work now. Obviously that groundwork is necessary, but it's always good to know where you're gonna go. So if you like the video, then I would very much appreciate it if you gave it a big thumbs up. And of course, if you are new here, then consider subscribing. I put out new videos every Tuesday and Friday. All right, so the first business idea that we're gonna speak about, obviously, is coaching. Now, specifically, I'm not gonna talk about business coaching, life coaching. This is just coaching as a whole. Now, the first thing I wanna address with this one is the age-old question that I get asked all the time and that I see so many debates going on in my collective group about is, do you need a certification to coach? My hard, strong opinion on this is a no. Unless there is certain legalities and certain insurances that are involved with your particular niche. That comes under things such as medicinal, nutrition, personal training, and things of that nature. Legal, if you're teaching someone to be a lawyer, if you're teaching someone to be an accountant, there's certain types of accreditations that must be in place for you to actually work with those people. But any other type of coaching, I firmly don't believe that you need any type of certification. Certifications are amazing because they teach you things, but you can learn all of that online. I myself have a degree in business, and that's why I teach business. But you know, everything that I know, I could have learned through my experience, or I could have learned myself online through courses and coaching and mentoring programs. I don't necessarily think having a piece of paper that says, I learned how to ask questions for 4 years, is going to give you the skills, the expertise, and the results capability that you need as a coach. The only thing that's going to give you that is experience. So don't waste your time, don't waste your money. If you're thinking about coaching, you're much better to invest in a business coach or someone who's actually going to teach you how to coach and then work for free for a little while, get some experience, and that's how you can really grow your business. If you're committed to learning in no matter what niche, no matter what profession, no matter what industry, then you can succeed. It's all about knowledge and applied. Actually, it's not even all about knowledge. It's all about applied knowledge. You can learn everything, but unless you actually know how to implement, you're not gonna get very far with it. So, coaching is an amazing thing that you can start. Now, if you've got a certain skill, a certain passion, a certain area of expertise, then you can absolutely coach that. You know, some of the common ones are business coaching, but there's so many different types of business coaching. You could teach marketing, you could teach administration, you could teach people how to start their business, you could teach people how to grow their business, you could teach people how to hire people. There's so many areas of business that you could teach. What's your skill in? Figure that out, and then you can become a coach. You could be a life coach, a manifestation coach, a relationship coach, a single person coach, an independence coach, a confidence coach. Honestly, the coaching ideas are limitless. Really, just you need to figure out what value do you have that you can give to people? What's something that you know that, you know, a lot of other people don't, or what's something that you're committed to learning, and then go from there, build your business around that. So coaching's amazing, coaching is huge, and where can you go from there? Coaching is extremely scalable when you move into the passive side of coaching. So when you're starting out, it's very active, it's very, I'm trading time for money, I'm working with clients on a call, on a Skype call. But when you move your business to passive types of income, you know, Marie Forleo and her B-School, she launches that once a year, has what, 1500 intakes and $1 million intakes, basically. When you move your expertise into more of a course or more of a guide or more of an academy or something like that, then you can really get more people in the door for less work. You want to talk about laptop lifestyle, you see people who are living on a beach or doing all of this amazing stuff, it's because they're making money passively. And coaching is a really great step into that. And there's infinite ways that you can scale your business when you're working with passive products. So coaching is a huge one, and the way to move from there to where else to scale from there is to create passive products. My next example is if you wanted to do some type of, you know, virtual assistant, graphic design, web development type service. So this is more like freelance work. Maybe you're a photographer. So a freelancer, let's categorize it as a freelancer. Now, obviously you need a certain set of skills in one of those disciplines to be a freelancer in that area, but it's not to say that you can't start learning now if you had an interest in them. So just because you didn't study photography at school doesn't mean you're not an amazing photographer. It doesn't mean you're not like Peter McKinnon, who didn't actually go to school for photography, but worked in the industry for years and now obviously has an amazing channel on that. So you can absolutely get those skills, but provided that, you know, you can show that your work is good, of value, it's quality, then you can start a business providing those services for people. And where you can actually go from there is, first of all, you could do passive products as well. You know, you could create LUTs, you could create presets, you could sell your photography, you could sell your photography for commercial purposes, you could sell your photography for to other businesses. If you were a virtual assistant, you could create courses to train other virtual assistants. So you definitely can go from there in the passive route as well, similarly to coaching. Additionally, what you could do is you could even set up some type of school, some type of business. So you could set up a school where you taught other people how to become a virtual assistant or how to become a photographer, you know, online. Or you could set up a service where you hire a whole bunch of freelancers. So you could hire like 10 VAs and it's almost like you freelance them out. So you're doing the marketing and all of that to get the business, to get their services in front of people, almost like you're a directory for freelancers. You could even hire them as staff and they could do the freelance work. They could do the VA work for you, or it could be more of a directory with the freelance. But you could definitely set up some type of business where you're helping people to gain exposure because you've already built the business up, you've already got the audience up, and then from there, you're actually not doing any work yourself. Obviously, you have the CEO kind of management stuff. You could even hire staff for that as well. But the groundwork, the actual VA work, photography work, web design work, graphic work, could be done by other people, either by a directory or either by you owning the business and having the VAs work for you. So that's another idea for how you can actually scale that business up as well. The third thing, and this is, you know, you do have to have a particular skill for this, writing as a skill, is that you could write a book. And I think, you know, the opportunities that can come from writing a book are endless. You could get more book deals. You could obviously become a New York Times bestselling author. And don't say it's impossible, because it's not, because people do it all the time. You could have a speaking career. You could teach other people how to write. You could potentially get your books turned into movies or documentaries or shows. You could write for television. You could write for plays, if that's the kind of route that you were going down, the kind of fictional route. But whatever it is, you can get more book deals, and the more that you grow your audience as an author, the more that your book, this one little book that you might have self-published on Amazon, the more that that grows and your audience grows with that, the opportunities will open up from there. So categorizing yourself as a published author, who cares if you published your book yourself, you're still a published author. If you're someone who's actually published and sold books, you're a published author. So if you can write a book, whatever that may be, on whatever topic that you want to talk about, then from there you could do TED Talks, you could do, as I said, public speaking, you could do events, anything around that subject matter of that book, you could hold events in. So classifying yourself as a published author is a really great way to scale your personal brand. But all you simply got to do in 2018 to get yourself to that stage is write that book. And in my next business, and I'm going to say business, that you can start in 2018, I'm going to talk about YouTube, but this kind of classifies podcasting and blogging as well, but I'm going to talk about it from a YouTube sense. You can start a YouTube channel, and yes, that absolutely can be a business. A business is anything that solves a problem and makes money. So right from the get-go, even if you've got zero subscribers, If you can find a way to make money, you can absolutely start a business as a YouTube channel. You know, there's so many different ways that you can make money from having a YouTube channel. And I've spoken about this in a previous video. I will link it somewhere on the screen or in the description below. But in terms of actually having a YouTube channel, classifying yourself as a brand right from the beginning, that is definitely a business that you could start. Now, before you start saying, oh, you need to have like a million subscribers to actually make any money, yes, that is true for AdSense. I myself have what, over 50,000 subscribers? I make $200 a month roughly from my YouTube channel from the AdSense. We're not talking about AdSense here. We're talking about you having your own uncapped earning potential income sources. That could be an ebook, that could be a course, that could be a done for you service, that could be a coaching service, any of the other things that we've spoken about here today. But a YouTube channel, you can actually monetize this in your own way in the beginning and then obviously grow from there. Now, I want you to actually go and research an article. I'll leave it linked below, but have a look at an article by Kevin Kelly called 1,000 True Fans. You do not have to have a large audience to build up a profitable business. You just need to have an engaged audience. Numbers are nothing. Engagement is everything. So YouTube absolutely can be a business. And where do you scale from there? Gosh, I'm almost embarrassed to talk about this one because it is endless. Look at what some of the YouTubers have done. You could start businesses, you could start speaking, you could write a book, you could be in movies, you could be in TV shows, you could interview the president. We all know where YouTube can lead you. But it all starts with you actually being able to make money, to be able to invest your time into creating better videos, to creating better content, to getting people on your team and things like that. But it all starts from you actually picking up the camera and making those YouTube videos initially and making some kind of revenue from that. So I actually am starting a YouTube course that launches in a couple of weeks now, which if you're interested in, I will leave the information below. It's all about having YouTube as a business. How do you actually start and grow a YouTube channel and how do you make money from that? So if you're interested, I'll leave the information below. There's an awesome early bird special on at the moment, but YouTube is a business and the scaling opportunities are endless. And then the final one that I did want to talk about was starting some type of e-commerce business. Now there's so many ways that you can go about this in the beginning. The most popular really are to drop ship, meaning that you are building some type of site, getting other people's products, whether it be like Amazon or I think there's ClickBank, there's lots of different stores that you can get. So you're promoting their products, but it's warehoused by them. So when someone buys from your store, you pay commission to the site, but they ship it for you. So you actually don't have to manage any of the logistics. Now that's obviously a great way to set up the store in the beginning and it can be very profitable provided that you work on building that audience. Or you can contract manufacture your own products. So if there is something that you are interested in, whether it be like skincare, clothing, home decor, journals, stationery, then you can actually find a contract manufacturer for that product, invest a little bit of money in the beginning and start selling those products. Granted that you'll probably have to pack and ship them yourself in the beginning, but that's fine because I'm sure your order quantities aren't going to be through the roof. But it just takes the time to set up the actual store. And you could do that so easily now with either WooCommerce and WordPress or Squarespace, the shop version, so the upgraded shop version. But all you gotta do is build a website, attract audiences with social media, maybe a blog or something like that, position yourself as an expert, position yourself as a thought leader, someone who really knows about this product that you're selling, have a store link, link your store, sell your products, and it will snowball from there. It might be slow in the beginning, that's fine, but as you grow, as your audience grows, then your store will grow as well. How do you think most e-commerce, bricks and mortar commerce, bricks and mortar stores start? They all start from starting slow and it's snowballing from there. And then in scaling terms, gosh, again, the opportunities are endless. With e-commerce, the best thing about them, in comparison to all of the other things that I've mentioned, is that they can have an exit. Meaning that you could build this business up so much and sell it. Provided that you've got no emotional attachment to it, how people become, you know, billionaires overnight is that they build businesses up and then they sell them for an extreme amount of money and then they obviously reinvest into something else. But that's the possible future for you. You could franchise, you could sell into other stores. If you had a really, really amazing product, you could start selling to Maya, David Jones, or Selfridges, or I'm trying to think of other department stores in different countries. I don't know any. You could sell into department stores, you could sell to other stores, but creating yourself a physical product is a really good way. But the only problem is it does obviously require that initial capital, just a little bit of money to get you going. Try find a manufacturer that has a low MOQ, minimum order quantity, is my advice on that. So I know this was a long kind of rambly one, and granted, I know a lot of people aren't actually going to be interested in this. I really, really hope that that gave you an idea of things that you can do this year to start yourself to a journey of ultimate success. It always takes work in the beginning, but knowing where you can start and knowing where it can lead you and having a clear visual of that journey is a really, really good place to start in all of this. Like, understand that if you want to get to this kind of ultimate success, laptop lifestyle, freedom, girl boss lifestyle, you have to do that groundwork. Think of even the girl boss movie, I was gonna say book. She started selling on eBay and then scaled from there. Scaling is the word for growth. So think about it in terms of that. I hope that this helped you, give you some ideas of where you could be and where you could go. If you do have any questions about anything that I've spoken about in this video, please do leave them in the comments below. I'm happy to type away and give you in-depth answers to any questions that you do have, because obviously I can't cover everything in this video. I hope that was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. If you stayed to the end, you're a legend, you're a hustler, you're gonna make it big, you're gonna be ultimately successful because you've got persistence and patience. So thank you so much for watching, everyone. I'll see you in the next video.